I went to school for blind people from grade one, so automatically that's the main method of reading and writing. So I started reading Braille. As you guys are learning ABC in grade one, that's how I learned to read. That was my first way of reading and writing. And one of the great books that I've read in Braille is The Long Walk to Freedom, and by former President Nelson Mandela, and it's a very great book. And it's nice to read in Braille in the sense that you can be sitting in a dark room, you can still read in bed. It's very convenient because it gives you that freedom to say, I'm not really depending on audio, I don't need electricity. You can just sit, be alone, and be able to enjoy your own book. I actually learned to type on a computer only when I was in then standard 5, now grade 7. That's when I learned how to use computers. But whichever way, we both learn to appreciate the same type of message, the same type of reading, in the sense that I could be sitting with someone who can see and I could be reading something for them in Braille. I've read some authors from Africa. I read Left to Tell by Immaculée, you know, the lady who survived the Rwandan genocide in 1994. I was lucky to find that in audio. And I read, it's one of the few books that I've read. But most of our South African authors, I don't know, maybe they don't really invest in having their books in audio. And I think that's what South African authors should really look into. Because even people who can see, they will be in their cars. I share my audiobooks with my friends who can see, because they say, you know what, when I'm listening and I'm going to the office, it just gives you a good feeling.